In this video, we are going to study about the metathalamus. The metathalamus consists of the medial and lateral geniculate body. These are small rounded elevations on the inferior aspect of the posterior part of the thalamus. So this is the posterior part of the thalamus. So inferior to the posterior part of the thalamus, you have two bodies. One is the medial geniculate body and lateral geniculate body. And these are either side of the midbrain. The medial and the lateral geniculate body are the relay stations for the auditory and the visual pathways respectively. In this image, so this is the pulvinar of the thalamus. So when this is retracted, you can see two bodies. So this is the medial geniculate body and the lateral geniculate body. And this is the superior colliculus and this is the inferior colliculus. The superior colliculus is connected to the lateral geniculate body through the superior brachium or the brachium of the superior colliculus. The superior colliculus is connected with the lateral geniculate body through the superior brachium or the brachium of the superior colliculus. The inferior colliculus is connected to the medial geniculate body through the inferior brachium or the brachium of the inferior colliculus. So the superior colliculus, superior brachium, lateral geniculate body, inferior colliculus, inferior brachium and the medial geniculate body. So now we'll study about the medial geniculate body. The medial geniculate body is an oval elevation on the inferior aspect of the pulvinar of the thalamus lateral to the superior colliculus. It is more prominent than the lateral geniculate body. The inferior brachium runs upward laterally forward from the inferior colliculus to the medial geniculate body. So this is the inferior brachium. It runs upward laterally and forwards from the inferior colliculus to the medial geniculate body. Next we'll see the connections. The auditory pathway through the lateral lemniscus either directly or after a relay in the inferior colliculus. So these forms the afferent. These fibers passes through the inferior brachium. The efferents are the geniculocortical fibers or the auditory radiations. So these efferent fibers passes through the sublentiform part of the internal capsule to the primary auditory area in the temporal lobe, the area number 41 and 42, and the function is they act as a relay station for the auditory impulses. Next we'll see about the lateral geniculate body. It is a small ovoid prominence visible at the terminal end of the optic tract. It is situated on the inferior surface of the pulvinar, anterolateral to the medial geniculate body. It is smaller than the medial geniculate body and it is connected to the superior colliculus by the superior brachium. When you see the structure, the gray matter of the lateral geniculate body consists of 6 layers or laminae separated by nerve fibers. The laminae 1, 4 and 6, they receive the fibers from the retina of the opposite side, and the laminae 2, 3 and 5, they receive the fibers from the retina of the same side. Next we'll see the connections. The afferents of the lateral geniculate body or the lateral root of the optic tract, which consists of most of the retinal fibers of the both eye, the temporal fibers of the same side and the nasal fibers of the opposite side. The efferents are the geniculocalcarine fibers, which forms the optic radiation, passes through the retrolentiform part of the internal capsule to the visual cortex of the occipital lobe, the area number 17, 18, 19. Function, it acts as a last relay station on the visual pathway. When you see the comparison of the medial and the lateral geniculate body, the medial geniculate body is a oval shaped collection of gray matter on the inferior aspect of the pulvinar, whereas the lateral geniculate body is a bean shaped collection of gray matter on the inferior aspect of the pulvinar. The hilum is absent in the medial geniculate body. The hilum is present in the lateral geniculate body. There is no lamination in the medial geniculate body. The lateral geniculate body consists of 6 laminae number 1 to 6 from ventral surface to dorsal surface. The destruction of the medial geniculate body on one side has little or no effect on hearing, whereas the destruction of the lateral geniculate body on one side produces the blindness in the opposite half of the field of the vision. The medial geniculate body acts as a last relay station on the auditory pathway. The lateral geniculate body acts as last relay station on the optic pathway. The medial geniculate body sends auditory impulse through auditory radiation to the auditory area of the temporal lobe. The lateral geniculate body sends visual impulses through optic radiation to the visual cortex of the occipital lobe.